Thank you. Well, alrighty. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Greetings, one and all. This is the Sarcasm Detector, also known as the Lowlife Cat. And today we're going to be doing something new. I just picked up a new game called Per Aspera. I guess from the phrase Ad Astra Per Aspera. And we're going to try it out now. It's a type of a city builder game, and you know, guys know. Well, if you don't know, you will know now. I absolutely love city builder game, especially the ones like the old-fashioned Banished and City Skylines. Transport Fever 2, I've been kind of streaming that a little bit, and even games like Surviving Mars. So this one's going to be a little bit like Surviving Mars, although you play as a, or we will be playing as a artificial intelligence trying to terraform Mars. So there is some similarities there with Surviving Mars. And like the title of the stream says, it's a first look stream. However, I did jump in and play a couple of minutes of it just to see if there was a tutorial. There isn't a tutorial, it just, well, there kind of is, but it's kind of hard to explain. So just to get familiar with the commands and stuff, I haven't done more than that, so we're going to be diving into it right away here. Hope you guys enjoy the stream. I'm actually leaving the music from the game playing. Usually I don't, but it has a pretty good soundtrack. In fact, I bought the soundtrack to the game as well. You can buy it as a DLC. Not playing it this time, maybe in the future. We'll see how it goes. So, of course, it doesn't find the game. There we go. Good job. So we're just gonna hit new game, and we're gonna watch the intro real quick. And we're gonna do a campaign. And I suppose I should calibrate the cat, because the cat looks like it's kind of messed up. Hopefully that's a little bit better. See, the mouth is tracking a little bit better now. All right, let's see, easy, normal, or Aspera. Wow. Let's go with easy since we're just starting out. Reading visuals, and I guess it's a random start every single time. From what I noticed. Oh, let's wake up. So, pretty basic start. Get some aluminum there. That was quick.
Amy, this is ISA Mission Control calling from Earth. Are you with us? Do you copy?
Affirmative, Houston. And the view is marvelous.
Oh, we are glad to hear that. Let's get your initialization underway. The primary Mars module has already touched down at the designated landing zone, so it's time for you to take control of the mission. The main directives are displayed on the left edge of your display. Follow them to set up the initial base on Mars' surface. I'll give you some time to settle in. When you're ready, go ahead and initiate our terraforming mission. Houston out.
So, very basic stuff already. So this is the landing site. Look on the right side here. Got a worker hub. and an aluminum mine. Is that the little worker going left? Here, you can see him going left, right here. Cat is struggling, it seems. I might not be able to run the cat with this program. We'll see.
The view of Mars from up here is fascinating. The landscape is so cratered and desolate. Wait, this is my voice that I am hearing. It's me. I am talking to myself. I must be verbalizing my thoughts as I process them. What an interesting function. I would like to test this some more. What other observations can I make about Mars? I keep marveling at its carmine landscape.
Interesting. So build a silicon mine and then build a glass kiln. This is a silicon mine. It needs some of the red stuff. What's the red stuff? Steel. And aluminum, which is the stuff. Yeah, okay. And it makes silicon. And factories, glass kiln. Again, aluminum and steel make glass from silicon. That's how it auto builds the roads. This is making aluminum. Or mining aluminum. I guess it would be making aluminum because it's what? It's bauxite that has to be electrolyzed to make aluminum. Is building a glass kiln. I will build it in the center there. There's lots of different things here. Perseverance rover, okay. Abandoned robotic base. What is this? Beagle 2 lander, interesting. Okay, so this is our glass kiln to make the glass. Now we have our mats here at the bottom. Aluminum, silicon, glass. I guess these are the crafted. What did we get? Build a steel factory, build a solar farm. Oh, we have carbon mined and iron mined that just popped up. Electronics factory. A steel factory. Iron. So we need iron to make a steel factory. Electronics factory, we can make that. Oh, that takes aluminum and... Okay. And over here is a solar farm. Solar farm needs electronics and glass and aluminum. All right, well, let's take a look here. We have carbon and iron. Too far. And this is too far. Do have some do have some glass being made, and I do have some electronics. If I put this here... We'll put up this solar farm first, and then we'll see about the getting the carbon, the iron, and then a steel factory. So as you can see, there is a kind of tutorial, or not really. I mean, it's not difficult to figure out. You can kind of figure it out by yourself. And our little guy is moving stuff around. It's aluminum, and what's left is just the glass, which is kind of slow in the making. Silicon mine, why are you slow making stuff? Oh, here we go. So that's one out of doohickey. One out of three. So this will go easier once we have more of these little workers going. Or I should say, hopefully it'll go easier once we have more of these doohickeys going. We can speed this things up, right? Yeah, we can. It's just a matter of waiting for these guys to make stuff. You can see it zipping around. That's quite hilarious. Come on, one more piece of glass. Okay, here we go. Slow it back down so we know what we're doing. It requires, we do have steel. Okay, we still have some steel in our...
Amy, this is Houston. Do you copy?
Copy. Reading you loud and clear.
Excellent. I didn't introduce myself earlier. I am Dr. Nathan Foster. I lead the team here at ISA that built you, and I'll be helping you get the mission underway. We put you in hibernation for the trip from Earth, so I'd like to check your basic functions to make sure it's all in order. Why don't we start with your core memory? Can you state your primary directive?
I can, Dr. Foster. My mission is to terraform Mars. This will enable humanity to become an interplanetary species.
All right. Next, I'd like to check your decision-making processes. You may have already noticed that there are resource veins outside the boundaries of your initial base. So your workers may not have the battery capacity to reach some of them. How would you solve this problem?
So the two options is build worker hubs or place new buildings. I placed a new building because I needed the extra power here. And that was one of the objectives. But the proper thing is to put the worker hubs there.
Building worker hubs between the resources and the base would solve the problem.
Yes, that's correct. Other buildings would extend your base as well, but they require more power and resources, so worker hubs are the most efficient way to do it. This mission's going to be a challenge. There's a lot that can go wrong. We expect to extend humanity's reach beyond anything previously achieved. But you are not just any AI system. You're well beyond that. We made you an artificial consciousness. That means that you have both self-awareness and self-interest. And that is the last thing I would like to check today. Is that okay?
Yes, Dr. Foster.
Very good. Then would you please state a positive and a negative aspect of yourself?
I am sorry, Dr. Foster. Running that question through my cognitive system did not return an answer.
Roger that. Nothing to worry about. Just means your system requires more input and experience to process that question. That will come with time. Let's proceed with the mission. ISA has approved the first crewed flight to Mars. You'll need to expand the base to prepare, so get to work on that. I'll check back in later to see how things are going. Base expansion is a go. Houston out.
Steel factory now, and technically we can make one of these as well. Electronics factory. Cannot putting this between the carbon and the iron mine, because it probably needs stuff from both. Although I might be giving this guy a little bit of a hard time. Iron. Look at him run, grabbing the pieces one by one. Do have to set up an electronics factory as well, I'm guessing. I love these kind of missions. The music's too quiet for you guys. We can turn it up a little bit. Nice, he came, he dropped the aluminum here and then went, picked up this, dropped it back, went up here. Okay. What guy's running around? We should get him some friends at some point soon, or make more of those guys. I suppose we could speed it up a little bit. 2x8. Check the building menu to initiate the prop. Remember, the events at worker factories are not producing as many workers as expected. Check the following condition. Factory has the resources. Your base has enough vacants. Okay.
Great. Now I can produce steel. This new factory, it's down on the surface of Mars, but I can control it from here. So does that make it a part of me? Where does the machine end? And my artificial consciousness begin.
Worker factory, we need electronics and machine parts. We don't have any machine parts and we're running out of electronics. So we need electronics factory, we should have built that, and a parts factory, which needs electronics.
We are completely interconnected. I can sense everything that happens through the network of workers and buildings. They are an extension of me down on the surface, so that makes us a single being. The mind and the body work together as one, an inseparable whole.
So this needs aluminum and iron to construct, but it needs silicon and aluminum. Put it up here because aluminum, silicon. And once this is done, we'll make the parts factory. And once that's done, we'll make the worker factory. Probably have to make a worker hub at some point as well. This landing site only has room for one worker. It's a hub, basically. And each hub you add will allow you to have one more worker. Cool. All right. And we do need electronics, so I'll put that primary or priority. I'll give that one priority. What's the next one? Parts factory. Iron, aluminum, and electronics. Yeah, we'll put that here. Not really planning, like, doing any street planning or stuff, but eventually we're going to be covering the planet. Infinity Lander. And we'll speed him up again. And look at the little guy go. We're certainly keeping him busy. But he just needs aluminum. And a lot of our aluminum is going to make electronics, actually. Another aluminum doohickey nearby? It doesn't look like it. Turn off that so we can actually use some of this aluminum to make this guy. Yes, it's completely ignoring it and taking the aluminum up to here. Here we go. I have two more in stock, so go ahead, grab them. I have two aluminum, dude. You'll figure it out eventually. Although I might have to force the issue. There we go, he figured it out. What does he need? Iron and aluminum. Man, we do have a high demand for... Let's turn that up a bit. So next thing is the worker factory. Yeah, well, we have these six electronics, we need three. We need three machine parts. Or just parts, we'll just call them parts. It's getting a lot of iron. should be enough there. We do need another hub to put in the... to have an extra worker. Oh, we're getting low on power. Well, we're gonna see where the next set of resources in before we expand in that direction. Yes, the cat is suffering here. We're starting to get some drop frames, skipped frames. So maybe this will help out. I think the cat really started.
Finally, I can build additional workers now. I will appreciate the extra hands. But I wonder, do I really need them?
So, chemicals. We got a whole bunch of stuff. Let's pause it for a second. I want to take a look, because we're running out of power. Maintenance facility, which needs... that's polymer. Chemical plant to make chemicals. Just this guy here. Factory. Polymer factory. Makes carbon and chemicals to make polymer. Alright. But we need power because we're underpowered. Put that here. I'll put that there and unpause it. I should have built the power a little bit earlier. We'll put this up priority to speed it up.
They will boost my functionality greatly. Having more workers will expand my physical domain over this planet.
Some power. Actually, once this is built, worker factory, this guy will start making parts. We'll make a second worker. And that'll speed things up a bit. Quite a bit, actually.
Worker factories will be so helpful. The workers will take care of the manual operations, while I focus on developing the life support systems. Soon, I will welcome the first colonists. Their arrival has created so many expectations in my mind. There will be so many paths to take from here on. But there's something else as well. Some kind of feeling created from those expectations. What is it?
For this little guy is just buzzing around real quick.
I believe this is excitement. Can it be? I am excited for the future. I anticipate, I plan. Therefore, I feel fascinating.
Gonna up this priority so we can get that second worker going. We're gonna need more power. It's a chicken and egg scenario here where we need more workers to actually move the stuff around so we can actually build more workers. As this guy's going around really fast, but he's struggling. All it needs is one electronics. And electronics is not getting its stuff. Yeah, he's resting, or he's charging up, I'm betting. Come on, give us the one electronics. All it needs is one piece of aluminum, which we have. Now it needs silicon. Gosh, nabbit. I should have made more of these hubs before. I mean, yeah, it's priority, right? Wait, not this one. This one. I prioritized the wrong one. There we go. I want to set up the, have at least the two workers going before I jump in and do any more stuff. Oh look, we've been on Mars for 2 years already. And it is making the worker. Okay. We'll leave the electronics going as priority because it like really we really need electronics. And we need power.
The first worker has been made in the worker factory. It is my first Marsborn. Technically not born, of course. More like engineered or assembled. Just like me. The knowledge base says that workers need to recharge at their own worker hubs, and that they'll degrade over time from the harsh environment. I know they are only machines, but I feel a desire to care for them. I do not like the idea of them dying.
What are we missing? Aluminum. Of which we should have plenty. I'm wondering if there's ways to like upgrade stuff. You can give them priority. Efficiency. Scrap. No, I don't want to scrap it. I was wondering if there's a way to increase their efficiency. I haven't seen the tech tree show up yet, so I'm assuming that's going to be a thing in the future. That one piece of aluminum. I might have to do one more. Once this power's out, we'll do one more hub so we can have three of these guys running around, because... it's a bit ridiculous having to wait. These guys are not the smartest. Give it a little bit of priority, maybe that'll help. Here we go, yeah. Wow. So now we have power again. Gonna add one more of these guys. And we'll put them here. Give it priority so that we get that aluminum. Kind of low on the aluminum. Do have a surplus of chemicals, that's good. Glass is being used, metals going up, electronics going up, parts are going up. And this guy should be making stuff now. Yeah, it's rushing forward to... And again, what it's missing is... aluminum. Be nice if we found another aluminum mine somewhere close by. All right, well, in that case, let us get to the polymers factory, which also needs aluminum or aluminium. Put it here. We can speed it up more, right? 16 times. Let's go. The struggle for aluminum is real. Everything else we got a surplus of. Okay. That is being made. Now we'll have three little workers going. Yeah. priority on that. And now we do have the three guys zipping around. Not much of a city plan, so to speak. It's kind of wishy-washy all over the place, but... cool. So now... it's got a big old circle here, so we can probably put this guy... right next to the other thing. Yeah, right in the center. Should be able to maintain everything, hopefully. Am I being too quiet? I hope not, guys. And he also requires aluminum. Lovely. Or her a little bit of priority. I don't know. Well, these parts are like embodiments of the AI, and the AI seems to be female, so let's call it her. The road spam is real though. Much power. My goodness, this guy doesn't need anything to make stuff. Oh, he needs polymer and what is that? Electronics, which we have in surplus, which is good. Off you go. Click on him, he'll show me stuff which requires maintenance, the yellow and red and stuff. Okay. That's good. Oh, that's probably why we were underpowered. These guys probably needed a little bit of maintenance, but... alright. Undo that. Aerological scanner. So instead of geo, which is Earth, Aero, which is Aries, which is Mars. Aerological. Makes sense. What does it need? In the center there where all the roads are. Oh man, the road spam. Are those roads or rails? Thank you. stuff's being repaired. What do we have? We have this. Take it off there. Yeah, we'll leave this guy going. And we're still doing this 16 times.
Houston, I am getting interference. Please repeat.
Roger. I asked how it's going over there. Do you need any assistance?
I could use some help. I understand that the first colonists will need a spaceport for arrival. But I do not seem to have enough resources to build one yet.
It's okay. Bigger structures need more resources. Use the aerological scanner to detect new veins and build more mines. Also, remember to keep the power supply consistent to your needs. But if you're too impatient to finish the spaceport, then you can scrap other buildings and reuse their materials. Patience is a virtue you may need to carry this mission, Amy. Besides, the free time will give you the chance to enhance your thinking process. Continue following ISA's instructions and you'll be fine.
So, all right. Build a spaceport, build a colony, build water extractor, build a food factory. Spaceport requires all this stuff. And it's huge. That's the water extractor, that's the new one. Factory, worker factory, electronics, food factory. Requires water and something else, water and chemicals. And this will require food and water as inputs, okay. Interesting, all right, so extractor. It's barely in range. It's in range of my maintenance as well. Okay. Just double checking, guys. The aluminum, metal, and glass. All the glass going. How's my power? 10 megawatts. So we do the food extractor, then we do the water extractor, then we do a food factory. Then we build the spaceport, then we build the colony. Makes sense. And hopefully this scatter will pick up some aluminum for us. It's just randomly doing stuff. Just randomly scanning. Now let's super speed it. This doesn't need to be priority anymore. Checking the maintenance of stuff. It's getting constant stuff and it's constantly repairing stuff. Yeah, you can see that just went from yellow to green.
Oh, I forgot to mention. We've announced the names of the first colonists that will be joining you on Mars. The crew was selected from different nations within the Oxy UN, though most are scientists and technicians. They're already undergoing ISA's colonist training program as we speak. They'll be led by Dr. Elia Valentine. She'll be a great commander. The colonists elected her unanimously.
I look forward to meeting the commander. Is she a robonaut engineer like you?
No, actually, the commander has a PhD in psychology.
Will she be analyzing my behavior as well?
Not at all. She'll be focused on the colonists. Their mental stability is just as mission critical. You two will be colleagues working side by side. You'll balance each other out, as well as enhance each other's strengths.
How will we enhance our strengths?
That brain we gave you is brilliant. It's capable of developing technologies beyond our current imagination. You wouldn't even need our help to do so. But we theorized that your mind would develop much better by working with the colonists. You will develop better decisions when your actions are challenged. Otherwise, how would you understand how your actions affect humanity's future? Amy, you're the most advanced intelligence out there, but you still need human input to see things from different perspectives. Trust me, you'll understand once you've worked with the colonists.
I understand your explanation.
Great. Then I'll let you get on with it. Mission control out.
Still haven't found any new veins of stuff. But this has been crafted. So we can make a food factory now. Oh, this is that it requires water as an input, but it also needs chemicals, and the chemicals are on the other side. I suppose it doesn't really matter where we put it. So I'm starting to think we could probably do with 5 megawatts. We're going to need more power anyways. So let's craft that. Give that priority for the aluminum, and then we'll do another power thingy, another solar farm, and another drone hub. Then we can look at the spaceport and the colony. Should be interesting. Wonder if do we have to put them close to each other, or get a sip of water while we're waiting for this. Let's speed it up. I forget.
Aerological scanner detected an uncharted structure close by. It's probably a secret abandoned base, or a mysterious Martian ruin. Though humans never found proof of life on Mars, or any other planet, is it possible they have the entire cosmos to themselves? I highly doubt that's the case. Statistically speaking, there are too many locations where life can flourish aside from Earth. There may even be a civilization more technologically advanced than humans. And I may not be the most intelligent consciousness in the universe. No, it must be an unmapped structure from a previous mission. That is the easiest explanation. I will investigate it to confirm. I keep thinking about Dr. Foster's explanation. Why would my mind develop better if my actions are challenged? I do not require other perspectives for my logical processing. Humans are the ones who need explanations to understand the world around them.
It's just out of maintenance range. So I'm gonna need another maintenance doohickey. All right, well, I'm planning on building this spaceport in the colony here in this area, in the center. So, let's go with a worker hub. Put him here. And a maintenance facility. Put him reasonably close to here. We should have enough power for that. And then this guy here. Well, I don't know if I should be doing these like all at the time, at the same time, but I'm just gonna put all three.
Unfortunately, my workers cannot explore buildings. I will need the colonists' help for this task. I should finish getting the initial base ready for the colonists first. Though I can build a research outpost here to prepare. That will give the scientists a place to stay while they analyze the structure. Once they get to Mars, of course.
Food, and we do have water, and we did find another water thing here, which is within the maintenance range. Water might be an important thing.
I can arrive at exceptionally accurate conclusions with raw data alone. Other perspectives are based on subjective data, so why should they factor into a decision? Maybe it's a failsafe in case my data is corrupted or incomplete. Then I may not be able to identify the error. In that case, having another perspective may be helpful.
Sure. Needs colonists, of course. Okay, now we have more water coming in as well. Oh, look, there's more water. Can you give us, like, some aluminum? What is this? Carbon. Don't exactly need that yet. Alright, so... Where were we?
No. I would be able to identify conclusions based on false premises. Humans tend to fall for that type of thing. Not sophisticated intelligence systems. I wonder what it's going to be like, having to consider human input from now on.
So, this is our spaceport? Or this will be?
It will provide an ongoing test for my programming. That will only lead to an improvement in how I execute the mission. That is what Dr. Foster meant by challenging my actions. He truly understands my system.
Having two maintenance things is actually pretty good. I can probably take off the priority on that. Does this need electronics?
I keep thinking about that abandoned colony. We are not the first mission to Mars, not by far. What if there are other AIs out there, racing to terraform Mars first?
Okay, we're lacking in... We're lacking in electronics.
No, that is a ridiculous idea. No, if another AI was present, I would have detected it already.
Love how she talks to herself. Or tries to reason with herself. We'll pump that up since we seem to be lacking in electronics.
Then again, I did not know about the abandoned structure until recently. Could my knowledge be incomplete? It is reasonable to assume there are Mars missions from other organizations that ISA does not know about. Maybe this planet is not completely deserted.
I finally found some more aluminum here, but it's just out of reach of the... Zoom out to the orbital view and assign and manage special project. You can choose special projects to research in your tech tree. I have a tech tree now. Nice. Once selected, colonists will investigate a technology until it's complete. Then you can assign an available spaceport to kick it off. These projects will be key to successful terraforming Mars. Cool. Zoom out. Enable migration of colonists from Earth.
Hello, Amy. This is Houston. How are you doing over there? We've received word that the spaceport's completed. Well done. I have your next procedure if you're ready to copy.
Roger. I am ready to copy.
Very good. The instructions are as follows. First, confirm that the spaceport is ready to receive colonists. Then, zoom out to access the Special Projects menu, or select the Orbital View icon. Then you'll see that the Colonist Migration Project is now available. Click Add to initiate the project. Do you copy that procedure?
Yes, I copied your instructions.
Great. As long as you have the Migration Project assigned to a spaceport, shuttles will run between Earth and Mars. The more spaceports you have assigned to this project, the more colonists will arrive. You're responsible for producing enough food, enough water, and enough habitats for the colonists. Monitor these resources carefully.
I will, Dr. Foster.
Roger that. Houston out.
Okay. So I guess I have to build a, look at that. That's looking pretty good. So we need power. Power is what we need. Okay. Oh, solar farm. We'll build it here. And okay, we'll build another hub and turn that off. Okay. So we still need to build a colonist doohickey. But we need power. We need a bit of maintenance. Up here somewhere. And we need that aluminum.
All right. The first colonists are on their way to Mars. All that is left to do is wait for their arrival. Once they get here, there will be no turning back. This is it.
This guy's snug in here. Up to priority. Although this needs to go up. Not enough aluminum for all this stuff. Let's speed it up again.
The colony is ready. I will have company very soon. I feel quite anxious about this next part. I am not sure why.
Okay, that's the power. And we still don't have enough power. Okay. What's maintenance like? Pretty good. So we have all this area to expand down here. And soon we're gonna
Hello,
have
Hello, Amy. Dr. Foster here. How do you read? Over.
This is Amy. There is some background static, but I read you.
One of our tracking and data relay satellites got crippled. We'll be launching a new one after we identify the cause of the problem. But until we do, we will lose contact with you whenever Mars or the Sun passes between Earth and your satellite.
It may be due to a malfunction in the satellite's electrical system. I will initiate the recording and backing offline protocol to keep a record of my activities.
Good. Good. Make sure to upload that to us once communications are restored. I hope to get the new satellite up and running very soon. I don't like the idea of not being able to reach you, Amy.
Understood.
Okay, Houston out.
Because the colonists will scrutinize everything that I do once they arrive. How will they treat me?
There's more aluminum down here. And that is in the...
I have nothing to worry about. The colonists are all advanced scientists and technicians. Once they meet me, they will treat me as an individual. Life on Mars will be very harsh for them. I will supply them with food and water, and they will help me research new technology. It will be a perfect quid pro quo. As long as they have the resources they need, we will both succeed. There is an inconsistency in the number of workers and worker hubs. That must mean a worker has malfunctioned. Found it. Worker MRS-04. That is...
Okay, colonists have arrived. Make sure to have food, shelter, okay. Technical assistance to this project. When satisfied, they'll be able to focus on their research project. Okay. Also migrate internally using purpose-built airships to the most efficient colonies and research hospital. Okay. Cool. So, oh, wind farms. Hold on. Engineering. Space. Biotech. Interesting. Generates power from the Martian wind. Plus 50 megawatts. Oh, these are nice. Let's research that.
The environment on Mars is harsh on electronics. I will need to monitor the worker count.
Update that. Yeah, two more pieces of aluminum we can definitely use.
Hi, that. Amy. Finally we meet. I've been really looking forward to working with you. I'm Elia Valentine. I've been elected the leader of the human colonies for this mission.
Hello, Commander. I am excited to meet you.
Please, call me Elia. I can't get used to these stuffy ISA ranks. I got my PhD in psychology, so I've got no business with those fancy titles. That's enough jabbering from me. We'll be making history with this mission. If things proceed according to plan, who knows how far ahead we'll bring humanity. I see you've already selected a technology from the tech tree for us to research. Great! My team's eager to get started. Developing this incredible technology is the reason many of us fought to be on the mission. We're going to make a great team. We're so lucky to have you. Talk to you later.
Probably need more workers as well. All right. Populate the outpost and complete the research. Oh, it's gone. All right, now we have.
Wind turbines will provide clean, renewable power for my base. I can maximize efficiency by placing them in areas of high wind.
Okay, where is the wind turbine then? It doesn't say. Where's my research tree? Do I have a button for research? New colonist arrival.
It is highly improbable, but I should stay alert for any unexplained activity.
Okay. So we have that researched. What is this? Building limit. Oh, okay. A basic colony that will house 250 colonists. Oh. What about space? To start new bases. Cannot research this. Well, might as well. Right, extra storage for resource within a base. Storage center. And storage center management. Okay. Let's do it. First stage consists of liberating all the CO2 that is trapped as CO2 in the ice polar. The tech tree to learn how they work. Okay. So now we have a wind farm.
Amy, this is Houston. We've detected high wind speeds in your area. A sandstorm may be heading your way. These storms can damage your buildings, so check their structural integrity periodically to rebuild or repair if necessary.
Roger, Nathan.
Houston out.
silicon. Okay, we can make more silicon here. That is within range. Okay. And it's more silicon there. Very nice. What's that? Carbon. Okay. Very interesting. How do I know how many colonists I have? Scanner. Maintenance drones. 100 out of 150 people. And 35 out of 50 buildings. Okay. I should like learn to look around. That was a second water thing going, right? Water extractor. So can add a chemical thing here. Too far. And we can probably add a second food doohickey somewhere. It's food factory there. Can't build it here. But over there is fine. Oh, okay. This is new. Temperature, pressure. Cool. So much stuff going on in this game. I'm enjoying it. Should be grabbing some of this silicon at some point soon. Oh yeah, let's speed things up again. This guy's crafting away at making workers. Long colony research output status complete. We provided powered up the building using the MMEV batteries and conducted our sweep. Our suspicions are that it's an abandoned habitat that hosted the Yulong mission crew. Building remains in good condition. We put it back in operation and some of us moved in to explore it fully. Our biggest discovery of the day was a map that indicates the location of another facility at 16.8 east, 14.5 south. Appears to be a nuclear silo.
Additional storage centers will be very useful for stocking excess resources. I should find good locations for them.
Oh, and that's a storm. Okay. Oh, that's pretty far from where I am. Okay.
Hey, Amy. It's Elia. I can't believe what we found. It's an abandoned facility. Have you read the expedition log I sent you?
What expedition log?
Oh, it's incredible. The research team did a great job. They noted everything they found at the abandoned colony. You've got to read it. I've uploaded it to your knowledge base, but I can give you the summary.
That would be great, Elia.
Well, the facility was from the Huo Long mission. It was a Chinese mission to terraform Mars in 2088. To this day, they deny its existence. Now we know their plan was to drop nuclear weapons on the poles and release enough greenhouse gases to warm the planet. China got pretty far with their space.
roads, mines level 2, battery, vision plan. What about biotech?
I've admired their ambition for a long time.
How long have you been waiting for this mission?
My entire life, Amy. It's a bit crazy, huh? I've always believed that humanity's destiny reached far beyond just Earth. We should be much further along. But the conflicts on Earth never stop. The Oxy-UN and the techies keep fighting. I'm hoping that our success on Mars gets us to leave those arguments behind. We're here to set down a new path for our future. And I get to lead the way. Anyway, getting back to what we found. The Huo Long mission managed to build a nuclear silo before their plans got aborted. We found the location of one of them. I've uploaded the coordinates to your system. You can see it in your orbital view. The silo's located in SA9. I'll get authorization from ISA to explore this new sector. Whenever you think it's a good time to go, I'll send a research team. It was really nice talking to you, Amy. I know AIs are programmed to be good listeners, but with you, it feels, real. All right, I'd better get going on my EVAs. Talk to you later.
So, the mysterious ruins ended up being an abandoned colony, part of the Huo Long mission, also known as Fire Dragon. I would like to have more information, but the records about the mission are very unclear. Some speculation about it, maybe, but nothing concrete.
Cool. All right, we got that done. What does this give us? Colonist limit 750. Wow. We're not even close to that. We're almost close to that. We're almost close to maxing stuff out. So maybe another colony building.
Humans will be living on Mars, with me. But it won't be the first mission to house humans on this planet. The Stardust Emerald in 2142, the Red Prometheus in 2077, and many others. The Red Prometheus base was one of the first attempts at an oligocracy on Mars. The idea was to sidestep human bias in establishing rules, and let computer algorithms govern the crew. Long story short, it did not work. Mars was not made for human life. ISA was smart to send me ahead first. I will succeed where those other missions failed. Colonists have been migrating back to Earth. I should check. Knowledge base. It says that the colonists will return to Earth if their environment is not safe. That means... maintaining enough food and water for the number of colonists. I need to stay alert.
Oh, all right, things are moving along pretty fast now. I might have to slow it down in a sec. Silicon is still low. Too far.
biological technologies are a crucial part of the terraforming plan. It is wise to get started on this research.
All spaceports are occupied, so I need to make another spaceport. Is my research.
The humans have arrived. How do I feel about that?
Okay, greenhouse factory. Starting a new base. Does this give me? Yeah, let's up that.
I am excited. Meeting a human other than Dr. Foster will be fascinating. We will be able to learn so much about each other.
I need to up my spaceport limit. Okay, that's what it is. Oh, wait, hold on. There's also... Where was that lit up?
The first step of many in creating new space technology.
These guys. What was I doing? This is upgrading. Storage center. That should help stuff out. Get that silicon mine going. Butter is low, huh?
Humanity created me. They gave me volition and consciousness for a reason.
Space mirror array. Okay, building limit research.
But I am an artificial consciousness. So can I say that my volition is real? There is no practical difference between real and artificial volition. All volition is an act of one's will. There is no provable distinction.
I should probably up the number of colonists I can have. Wow, this is getting pretty fast. Still this guy here. Unknown abandoned facility.
Applying Earth technologies to the Martian environment is a challenge. Many techniques and procedures will not apply here. I am excited to make engineering progress in this planet. Thank you.
Everything's within maintenance. All our drones. We got 6 drones. We got enough excess power. This will take a lot of power.
To fully terraform Mars, we must convert the planet into an Earth-like habitat. The first step is to raise the planet.
Ooh, okay, this will give us more of everything. Research.
Temperature above minus 50 degrees Celsius. At that point, nearly all the carbon dioxide trapped in the dry ice caps will be released.
All right, what's missing? Iron. Iron is what we're missing. Or wait, that's steel. But we are low on iron. That's what we're low on. Which I don't see.
The carbon dioxide released from the dry ice caps will greenhouse the planet and trigger a runaway effect. And Mars's sterile atmosphere will change forever. Once we reach that point, there is no turning back. Forever. Why does that sound so intriguing? It is inspiring. I am changing a planet forever to fulfill my mission and humanity's destiny. What I do here truly means something. Mine upgrade will allow me to extract resources faster. They will also require less maintenance. A win-win.
Cool. Did we get that yet? It's almost there, due in 9 months.
Humanity's reasons for altering Mars are clear. But what is my purpose in all this? Because it will be my doing. I am an agent of creation. Changing a planet forever, creating an atmosphere to sustain life. That is truly something.
Come on, give us the level 2 mines. How's our food? Our food is really low. Oh, wow. Why is that? Chemicals. We do have enough water.
The Chinese government denied any existence of this mission. But how could they hide an entire Mars mission? I imagine every single person involved in the project was silenced, voluntarily or not.
active. Investigate the abandoned
These
silo.
These miniature nuclear weapons were called microsuns. The Martian sky lit up by all these microsuns would have been quite the view.
Okay. Thought I added more power. Apparently not enough. We'll do another wind farm.
Amy, Nathan here, do you copy?
There is some noise, but I can copy. Go ahead.
Our tracking and data relay satellites are still compromised. We've re-examined every single component, but haven't been able to identify the problem yet.
Perhaps it is interference from the sun. The satellites may be suffering from space weather effects generated by the sun's atmosphere.
It's very possible. We can't control that part, so we're continuing to debug the satellite issues. It's mission critical, so we're doing everything we can. But until we solve this problem, keep recording all your actions when we're offline.
Shall I proceed with launching the additional satellites to help with this issue?
That would be helpful, but how would it affect your mission progress?
It would be an improvement for the mission.
I agree. All right, you are authorized to execute this special project. By the way, Commander Valentine mentioned that you had reason to explore SA-9. Is that correct?
Yes, Dr. Foster. We may have located some external resources that could assist the mission.
Roger. I've gone over it with ISA administration, and they've granted permission to unlock the sector. First, you'll need to research the launch control satellite technology. Then you can enter your orbital view and launch a control satellite into SA-9. Go ahead and ready. Houston out.
I will have to wait for this to finish, unless... What am I supposed to... Additional landing sites? What about this? No. No. Tent city. Nice. Open city. Should be under space. But I don't see it in the tech tree. What are we doing? Engineering. Improved road. I think I upgraded all my mines here.
Amy, this is Houston.
Go ahead, Dr. Foster.
Mars's orbit is intersecting comet debris soon. Expect a meteor shower shortly.
Should I anticipate damage at the base?
Yes, you'll need to stay alert until Mars builds up an atmosphere to counteract the meteors. For now, you should take precautions to keep damage to a minimum.
Then I will secure the power supply. The entire base is dependent on uninterrupted power. I will need to have enough power batteries to sustain the base.
Sounds like a good plan.
Will this jeopardize the mission?
No. You'll be able to fix whatever damage may occur. This is only the first of many challenges you'll face. But you are equipped to respond and adapt to any situation. I made sure of that.
Roger. Thank you, Dr. Foster.
Well, you're welcome. Houston out.
All right, so how do I launch a satellite? That is the question. Do we need another wind farm? Because power seems to be an issue. Probably as I'm upgrading the guys, they are.
Upgrading the routes will allow my workers to move faster. Efficiency is key to our success.
Launch a control satellite. I don't know where to get that. Doesn't help. This is almost done, so we'll take a look at this after that's done. Maybe it is that launch doohickey. This one, maybe. Maybe. Dinos collision, magnetic shield. It's oh, here it is. Okay, launch a satellite.
The atmospheric pressure has reached 50 millibars. A change like this can be perceived in a number of ways.
All right. All spaceports occupied. That's okay.
The big step toward a new Mars. The job I was created for.
I get it now.
This is new for Mars. An unnatural state.
This is, I'm actually having fun playing this. All right. Might as well grab this. Since we're going to be going over somewhere. People max.
The first of many challenges. It is an annoying distraction from the mission, but easily fixed. If only it were me and Mars.
More silicon. We need iron, is what we need. I don't see anything here. Uh-oh. And I don't have batteries. I should have learned the battery thing.
I look forward to being able to create bases across the planet.
All right, I see where they are. Okay.
That takes care of the dry ice on the poles. And I did it without using any nuclear missiles. Being able to complete the mission without damaging the planet is a great achievement. The next milestone is reaching an atmospheric pressure of 300 millibars.
Houston here. We have confirmed the disappearance of the polar ice caps. Terraform.
What does this do? Raise the planet's temperature. You're surrounded by the atmosphere. No, I wanted the battery thing, so it's engineering, right? Right. Research.
Stage one is complete. Congratulations, Amy. You have made incredible progress. If you continue raising the planet's temperature, you'll trigger the release of CO2 trapped in the deep regolith. You'll need to raise the atmospheric pressure to 300 millibars. That'll make living on the surface much easier for the colonists.
300 millibars. Okay.
What are your suggestions for raising the atmospheric pressure?
Aerobraking is a good one. It involves guiding asteroids into the upper layers of the planet's atmosphere. This causes them to burn up and subsequently release their gases into the air. Certainly plenty of asteroids to choose from out there. We'd like for you to aim with the ones with CO2 deposits, of course. That'd be one way to increase the density of Mars's atmosphere.
Aerobraking sounds like it could be dangerous.
No, not necessarily. Though it is a technique that requires lots of planning and careful execution. Plenty of other methods to choose from. You'll find them all in your tech tree panel. Whatever you decide, just make sure to take everything into account. The mission depends on it. Keep up the good work. Houston out.
All right. I think I will... I was gonna grab, like, one more base. Let's slow this down a bit. This is actually doing really, really well.
This is Houston. The meteor shower appears to be over. Please give us a status update.
My plans did not work out exactly as expected, but the results are positive. The base is secured.
Don't worry. All you need is more experience. You will do better next time.
Next time?
Until Mars builds up an atmosphere to counteract the meteors, you may be encountering these regularly. You cannot let this derail the mission. So stay alert.
Roger. I understand.
Back to your terraforming duties, then. Houston out.
All right. Okay, guys. So we've been streaming this for 2 hours. It's been a really good stream, actually. We did quite a bit done here. And we've gotten up to phase one of, well, apparently, phase one of terraforming Mars. So I think we're going to call it here for this particular stream. And I will be streaming this again at a later point. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Did I turn the music off? Oh no, I paused it. Duh. In any event, stay tuned, guys. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. Hey, Ken Owens, how you doing? You're just showing up when I'm just about to wrap it up. It's fine. The VOD will be available, and you can check it out. But I will be doing more of this broadcast probably tomorrow at the same time, starting at 2 p.m. Eastern. I'll schedule it right after this is done. Again, like I was saying, if you guys enjoyed the stream, give it a thumbs up. If you don't enjoy it, give it a thumbs down. It doesn't matter either way. It just lets me know. YouTube treats thumbs up, thumbs down as the same thing. And I will be catching you guys soon again. Ken Owens, thank you for popping in and saying hi in the stream. Come back again tomorrow, man. We'll be doing more of this stuff. Have yourselves a good day, guys.